Hello, 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 and welcome back to the Nexus Gaming Series. I am the Crushinator, and tonight I have an excellent Division C East, Division D East, Division E Heroic Division match for you. Bronze 6 taking on Big Push Power, Hardstuck Support Group taking on Heavy Break, Gen M Esports, and Unity. Here we go, go. There's the light bomb into the back. It's a stun onto four on that frontline sliding mosh. The tour bus catches them as well. Dragon Arrow is going to stun onto three. There's the follow-up from Ravar. Phoenix is going to get caught. Crown and... Whoa! ETC slides onto three and pops them all with the bump back. TomGen with the highlight play. Hello and welcome back to the Nexus Gaming Series. I am the Crushinator and today I have a Heroic Division best of three for you. Heroically challenged, taking on Durotan's Couch in tonight's matchup. The players have all been found. They're here in the lobby just waiting for the last readies to go out and we will jump into the draft. Thank you all for coming on out to support Nexus Gaming Series. If you're over on Twitch, make sure you hit that follow button to see every time I go live with another Heroes of the Storm cast. If you're over on YouTube watching live, hey to you as well. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe. You can get the not only the live cast, but you can get the spoiler-free VODs. You can get the game of the week. You can get the series in 60 seconds. All of it's over there, youtube.com/@crushcasts. Just make sure you check it out. Let's see what's going on with the maps. Heroically challenged, banning away Dragonshire and Infernal Shrines. Durotan's Couch removing Volskaya Foundry and Braxis Holdout. And we're going to start things off on Towers of Doom as chosen by Heroically Challenged. Readies are out. Let's go to the draft. Towers of Doom will be map number one. Durotan's Couch first to act here. We'll see what the plan is going to be. All right. Durotan's Couch. Longtime members of the Nexus Gaming Series. Heroically Challenged under yet a new name for this season. But a lot of long-standing players as well. How you doing, Golbar? I must tell you, though, I did have to replace the ear pads about 3 weeks ago. They finally crumbled into dust. And I had to get some replacement ear pads. But... still going strong with the headphones. Hope you're doing well, man. First ban here from Durotan's Couch. Going to get rid of Dahaka. Dahaka definitely a strong camp invader in the early going on Towers of Doom. Very difficult to gank. Heroically Challenged now with the next ban. I imagine we're going to be controlling the Johanna, the Brightwing, maybe seeing those globals. Gonna stick with the offlane ban, getting rid of Hogger next. Blaze, sort of our last remaining all-around offlaner. We'll see if that ends up being banned or if that's a high priority here. Towers of Doom, you're also worried about, you know, your long-range poke. Mephisto, Hanzo, Chromie, ones to prioritize, just to be able to delay the objective. Junkrat, another one. Going to be removed by Durotan's Couch. So do Heroically Challenged let Johanna through here? That would seem ill-advised, but there might be something else they're more concerned about, or maybe they've got a counter-draft for Johanna cooking up. It is going to be that Blaze ban. Meta Madness style draft? No, Heroic does not play Meta Madness style draft. This is a standard draft here in this division. Durotan's Couch first pick option. A lot of offlaners banned. I Just Fizzed is going to go ahead and pick up that Johanna first. one could be an early Leoric pick then. With all the offlaners banned away, Leo generally has a good matchup into Johanna. Brightwing Diablo, picked up quickly there by Moon and Bob. Okay. It does leave a Tychus possibility. Idioms will go ahead and grab it. Do we take Anduin now, or do we flex that pick? I feel like Anduin's not as high a priority here in Heroic. But it is possible just because it's a really strong engage tool. Wildcard's actually going to take that Leoric away. Quite good against Diablo as well, and also now you don't have to worry about Johanna having to go against Leoric. Nice pick up there. Heroically challenged. Thinking about their ban here. Gonna get rid of Genji. Genji's sort of a strong one all around. They've already got the Brightwing, so they might have been worried about an Anduin Genji flex there in the last couple picks. Yawner's also a well-known Genji player. How you doing, Valera? Hope you're ready for this set. Turtan's couch, see the Brightwing Diablo, maybe a Volibear just to be general. They're going to get rid of the Lost Vikings, okay. Little intel coming through there with the mid-ban. Leoric doesn't really do anything to the Lost Vikings, so just kind of going down the list of strong offlaners here. Heroically challenged. What do we have remaining? I mean, Urel's a solid one. Malfiel Zul can also do work. Shoopuff goes for Kira here. AoE rules on the Medivh. So we do have Medivh Diablo. Interesting. Kira, a very lethal offlaner, but does not clear super quickly. And Yawners goes for the Tracer. So that's definitely going to make rotations for the offlane difficult, unless Kira's the main damage, which would be very strange. Goliath on Rhaegar for the last pickup for Durotan's couch. I've got to think we're looking at something like a Hanzo or a Vala, just maximum damage output for the side of Heroically Challenged. But I wonder how they're going to set up their lanes with this Kira Medivh. Computex on the last pick. It is going to be that Hanzo. Okay. So in terms of gank potential gear, Kira pretty good at enabling those. Medivh able to port the team on top of Leoric. So Leoric pretty gank resistant, but could still be in trouble, especially with that Brightwing Polymorph if that's timed very well. And so I need to open up my mouse software so I can get the proper mouse profile. All right, let's get back to my camera. Game number one coming at you. On the left in the blue, we have Heroically Challenged. Moon on the Brightwing, Shoopuff playing Kira, AoE rules on Medivh, Computex on Hanzo, and Bob playing Diablo. On the right in the red, it is Durotan's couch. Seconds. Goliath on Rhaegar. Yawners playing Tracer. I just fizzed on the Johanna. Five, Idioms on four, Tychus. And three, we've got Wildcard two, on that Leoric.
Well, what are you waiting for?
Game number one is underway here. Leoric going straight to the top lane. Not wanting to duel with any of that mess here in the mid. Of course, stacking passively on that Q. Hanzo's going for Scatter Quest here. Trying to see if there's any other quests to be found. None that I can see. Bob going after Goliath using that portal to reposition. The Orc's cleared the top wave and it's going to start to rotate. Idiom stepping up here, throws a grenade into the back, trying to move in onto Bob, but a nice protect shield from Medivh denies that damage. Looks like Kira is going to move against Leoric in the mid. Tracer gonna move over to the right side camp as Medivh, Computex just stepping up to fight here. Kira coming on down. We got a full-on camp invade from Heroically Challenged. Wildcard a little bit light on health here, trying to work their way on the edge. They go after Goliath in this corridor. Yawner's going to move onto the point here as Johanna stepping in as well. Shupuff getting mowed down here by Idioms. Computex gets Yawners as Bob tries to keep on going in. There's the Protect Shield, but it's not enough. So many members low. Wildcard next to go down. Ponzo gets hit with the grenade. The overkill, it's not going to be enough. Duratan's Couch, though, retain their camp. Heroically Challenged. Big time brawl in the early going. Shupuff moving in there onto Idioms. Does not get the Q. Yawner stepping up, eating that E, though. Shupuff going to be in big trouble here. There's the reload, and Kira goes down. And we got a camp invade from Duratan's Couch. They're going to come over with Kira on the mend. Medivh portals the team in for a defense, though. Duratan's Couch decide they don't want that smoke. Leo and Tracer working on the top camp here as Kira's on the way back. Definitely pressuring Kira into having to clear extra waves is going to be a strength here. Tracer with a nice recall there. Shupuff has the trait to get away. As the sappers crash into the top tower. Goliath, whoa, almost walked into the wrong neighborhood there. Bob looking for a pin, not going to find Idioms. There's the polymorph onto Yawners, but Tracer able to blink back to safety there. Bob getting mowed down, receiving some healing. Moon, though, ooh, cleansed just a touch too early. Slow reapplied there by I Just Fizzed. That's Brightwing going down. Looks like we've got a 2-for-1 here. It was happening while all that went down. Heroically Challenged, getting the 2-for-1. Right side camp, still 30 seconds on that. As Duratan's Couch try to pick up this bottom tower. Hanzo's going to be wrapped up there as I Just Fizzed walking away. Medivh not going to be enabling another engage, though they're looking at Yawners here in the mid. Yawners blinking up, AoE rules looking to set up the portal. There it is. Yawners just keeps on trucking. That's three gathered up there by Johanna. Computex in some big trouble here. Overkill to press forward. And that is Hanzo going down. Six takedowns so far in this game as it looks like we've got a disconnect. R's are out. We'll get the 3-2-1 and then we'll jump back in. All right. Back into the action. Rotations will come through. Right side camps up once again. With Hanzo down, Heroically Challenged, probably not going to invade this camp here. So Duratan's Couch picks that one up. Head by about a level here. If they can hold out, they might be able to take an early level 10 fight. Bob repositioning to get away from the Tychus minigun. Nice work there. Got a double alter phase activating in the top side of the map as another fight has broken out here. Yawner's trying to move away from trouble. Idioms just pumping away into Diablo. Medivh finishing up that baseline quest as Idioms is going to get away just barely. Goliath did go for that dash range, Idioms went for the dash range on level 1. That is helping Tychus get out of these sticky situations. Fight continuing here. Moon is going to be taken out, as it looks like we have a simple trade on the top side for these objective captures. Duratan's Couch about to have their 10s here. And they're going to push it on this left camp. There are the 10s. Medivh just threatening with that portal. Camp stolen. We're looking at the Entomb, Ancestral Healing, Odin, Blessed Shield, and I never know which one the Tracer is. It is Sticky Bomb. So a little level advantage here. They're going to pop some of these ults as Diablo completes those souls. I guess boosting away from the portal just in case. Oh, Blessed Shield combo is huge, and that is Hanzo and Brightwing taken out. I just fizzed capturing them all, and the burst is immaculate. Bottom side structure goes down. Durotan's couch. Gonna set up for the next double alter phase happening on the bottom side of the map. In a strong position here. Heroically challenged. Just trying to soak up those level 10s so they're even on the next fight. How you doing, Russ? Welcome in. There are the 10s for Heroically Challenged. Got Leyline Seal, Apocalypse, Blink Heal, Dragon Arrow, and Unrelenting Strikes. Yes, that's what it's called. The Spinny Swirly talent. You know that one. Wrapping around here, Goliath sees Medivh overhead. Rhaegar, ooh man, it somehow got pinned there as Bob went on a journey. Leyline onto two, Apocalypse is going to come out. Nice unstoppable there from Goliath, but the Dragon Arrow still hits. Idiom's going to receive the Ancestral as Durotan's couch trying to turn this around. Johanna, though, very, very low. Johanna is going to go down. Nice interrupt on the ult of Kira, but not enough to get Johanna out of there. Leoric did manage to get the top side, so it's going to be a trade one for one, but still five shots for three. Durotan's couch going to come out slightly ahead on that trade. Though the core health's still even, as Heroically Challenged did pick up the extra shots in the early game. Leoric giving Medivh a bit of the business here in the mid lane, but as Medivh's already finished up that baseline quest, does not feel worried about brawling. Heroically Challenged going to grab their bottom structure back to even up the map. Wildcard sees Shoe Puff on the rotation. Looks like Durotan's couch. They're going to come in on this camp again. They do have level 13 advantage, but Leoric is not close. They decide to back away. There's Medivh portal. Trying to send the members on through. Dragon Arrow coming out is going to get us double stun onto the back line, but Blessed Shield responds. Shoe Puff trying to get the Unrelenting Strikes, but it pops onto only one. Kira healing up. Durotan's couch is trying to recover and back away. There's a nice... Wow, Leo catching three there. Tychus goes down. Wildcard was trying to cut off there. Did cut off further escape, but I think unfortunately trapped Tychus. That was a nice flank, but Durotan's couch could not get the turnaround. So Heroically Challenged. Gonna have an opportunity to try and control the bottom side here as a single alter phase is spawning in. Kira getting out of trouble. Tychus is now back as our next altar is getting ready to spawn. The Honors being a little bit careful there. Be swift, heroes. Be not. 13 Talenteers are ready on both sides. There's the Blessed Shield onto two. Moon with a nice cleanse, but Johanna catches them up. The short range is not going to be enough. This time Leo gets everybody. That's Hanzo and Brightwing taken out. Medivh trying to move away here. There's a Protect bubble. Tracer recalls. Oh no! The parting gift, not enough for the kill. Durotan's couch picking up four there. After the double kill. That time Leoric found their mark. Durotan's couch hoping to step up here. Take down this structure. We'll do so. Triple alter phase is coming up next. Durotan's couch trying to find their 16 advantage. As Bob searching here on the edge does not go after Yawners. Keeping an eye out here. Right side camp is up for grabs. 16s are here for Durotan's couch. They have successfully waited. Now they will press their advantage. The Honor's waiting on AoE rules. Gonna put Medivh down to half there. Coming across here is Durotan's couch, trying to defend the bottom structure that they claimed. Use their 16 advantage to create some space, as now the triple alter phase is online. Bob using the movement speed provided by Brightwing to reposition out of Tychus range. Sappers are stepping up here in the bottom lane. Leyline Seal onto two. They're trying to go for an Apocalypse combo, but Tracer gets out of trouble. I Just Fizz, the only one stunned. Sticky Bomb onto two here. Blessed Shield comes out. Diablo, no way out. Moon barely escapes there with the Blink Heal. They're looking at Hanzo. Shots are going to be traded here as Tracer blinks back to try to get another six shots. Leo has actually taken the top structure during all of this, so it's going to be another six going into the core of Heroically Challenged. Only mid tower remains here for the blue team. Diablo engaging. They do have 16 even talent here as they blink into the back line. They're trying to find this Tychus. Leyline Seal catches most of them. Wildcard stepping up is going to get stunned there. Tracer goes down on the point, but Bob falls as well. Moon, the only one in there. Idioms is going to jump on there. Leyline Seal hits everybody again. The Kira ult pops too soon, though. Shoopup just getting healing on everybody, though. AoE rules and Moon trying to get out of there. Wildcard running them down. One more. That's Brightwing and Medivh to fall. Shoopup trying to solo all of Durotan's couch. They're all so low. Wildcard trying to heal up and move back, but that is Leoric going down. Scatter is not going to find another one. Goodness gracious. Ends up being a 3-for-2 in that extended engage. Shoopuff nearly got them all down there. Hanzo trying to press into the bottom structure, but Idioms and I Just Fizzed. Oh, they're Goliath coming around as well. I want to get pinned here. Rise again. Brightwing coming on down is going to support Hanzo. Single alter phase coming up next. Kira trying to take back the top structure as Tracer pushes in more sappers. Just trying to clear these sappers to help push them in. Heroically Challenged, still 12 health on their core. So even if they don't take a structure back, the worst they could go down to is 6. Take the altars. They are coming down to fight here, though. Idioms is going to have one interrupt. I Just Fizzed in the back. It's caught in a Leyline Seal. Shoopuff misses on the Revolving Strike. Fight breaks out in the mid. There's the Protect Bubble. Shoopuff in some trouble here. Gets cleansed. Wildcard receives the Ancestral Healing. Short range stun and Polymorph, but Yawner's feeling good. The ult comes out once again from Shoopuff, but it is interrupted. Diablo and Kira are down. Leyline from AoE Rules hits onto three, but still Brightwing is run down. Computex trying to trade onto Wildcard, but Leoric backs out. Hanzo with nowhere to go here, trying to speed away, but the Tychus movement speed is so strong there. Ends up being a quad for Durotan's couch. They're trying to take the last structure. AoE Rules just playing around here. Mid is going to be taken down. Tychus getting 7 shots here, and this looks like it could be the game. Only one more to come through, and there it goes. It's flying across the map. Good effort, but a great game there from Durotan's couch. They go up 1-0. GG. Very cool comp there from Heroically Challenged. They found their engage a couple times there. But Durotan's couch with a lot of great purges from Rhaegar, a lot of great repositioning from Tracer and Johanna, just too many unstoppables. And Durotan's couch picks up the victory there. Very nicely played. Let's go to the postgame. Checking out the stats here. Computex on the Hanzo, 63,000 hero damage there for Heroically Challenged. Shoopuff on the Kira, top soak and siege damage. Over on the side of Durotan's couch, Idioms on the Tychus, leading the way with nearly 56,000 hero damage. Goliath, a zero-death game on the Rhaegar. Very nicely done. Take a look at the talents as we update the scoreboard. Get ready for game two. Alrighty. We are going to Battlefield of Eternity for game number 2, this time chosen by Duratan's Couch. We got the one ready. We just need the second. We're so close. We're so close. Second ready. Let's do it. Damn. Almost timed it out. Oh, goodness me. There we go. Second ready. All right. We'll get into this draft here in just a moment. Let's see if I can time it out. That was pretty close. I was a scooch late. Just a scooch. Pretty close, though. All right. Draft number 2 coming at you on Battlefield of Eternity. Heroically challenged. Going to be first to act in this one. See if there's going to be any major changes in band strategy here. And something I mentioned in previous heroic casts is that there's not as much draft reaction at this level because these players have such wide hero pools. So it's not like you see something, you ban it, and then the other team just has nothing to play. That tends to happen a little bit more at, you know, the letter divisions. Let's see if there's going to be any major changes. Sticking with the Blaze ban here is heroically challenged. Understandable, because Blaze is busted. Biggity busted is the Blaze. Duratan's Couch, next ban here. Battlefield of Eternity, you're thinking about your Hanzos, you're thinking about your Valas. Even Greymane and Raynor can make appearances here. Anubarak gonna be the ban from Duratan's Couch. Interesting. Anubarak very good at controlling a frontliner and diving past. So that makes me wonder if Duratan's Couch are trying to go with an immobile backliner like a Zul'jin or something. It could also be, you know, you think Anubarak ban, you think Cho'Gall comp. That seems a little bit precocious, but, you know, you're up one in this series, you could do something silly. Johanna the ban, this time from Heroically Challenged. Duratan's Couch. What do we got ban-wise? Gonna just take away the Hogger. So, lots of great options here for Heroically Challenged. They probably don't have to take like a Vala or Hanzo unless there's one they really prefer, because it's doubtful that Duratan's Couch just rips both of those off the top. You know, I wouldn't mind just like a Genji first pick here. Just control it, take it away from Yawners. AoE rules though says the Vala is more important. We're gonna take that one. Duratan's Couch. If they want to just put it on the table, then it's Anu and Genji right now. Is that going to be the play? What do we got here from Duratan's Couch? Prove me right! Uther Sonya. That's basically Anu and Genji. Wildcard picking up the Sonya. Goliath going for the Uther, so it's going to be possibly, you know, a Divine Shield leap into the back there. Uther, just a great follow-up stun, has a very nice cleanse, going for quick fights, that's where Uther tends to excel. Heroically challenged, let's see how they're going to support this Vala right now. Moon going for the White Mane, Computex going back to the Hanzo. I like the White Mane pick here, Sonya and Uther obviously both melee, more melee to come. And if it's just going to be a dogpile onto the front line, White Mane can reverse that damage very, very quickly. So that is a pretty cool pick here from Moon. Duratan's Couch seeing the double backline locked in here. See what sort of front line they don't want to deal with. It's going to be Garrosh taken out. Garrosh definitely good at isolating someone out of that comp. Heroically challenged. They see the Uther and the Sonya. Uther, sort of a classic gray main enabler. So that could be something to watch out for here. Maybe we'll just take away the Genji. Uther does enable Dragonblade Genji, usually, is how that is set up. See what the choice is. I just Fizz gonna go for Diablo. Yawners is gonna take that Zul'jin. Interesting. So they do end up going with the Zul'jin, but they've taken a very aggressive comp. Usually what we see with the Zul'jin is a team that just tries to, you know, hold themselves in the pocket and draw in the opponent and keep them there. You end up with stuff like Mei, like Tassadar, like Johanna, just keeping them in range of Zul'jin. They've gone very aggressive on the other side of this. Artanis and Muradin here for Heroically Challenged. Shoopuff picking up the best hero in the game. Getting that big 4-second blind into this team is going to be super effective for Heroically Challenged. Muradin great into auto attackers as well. I really like that rotation from them. Very light on CC, but they have a lot of just raw damage in their backline, so the CC not quite as important. Idioms on the last pick, gonna go for Stukov. It's just an all-in dog pile. We've got, wow, a double healer with the Diablo. Interesting. So it's a double healer with a single backliner in Zul'jin. Durotan's couch with a very interesting draft here. I feel like they could be in trouble versus this Heroically Challenged comp. All right, game number two coming at you on the left in the blue. It is Heroically Challenged. Computex on the Hanzo. AoE Rules is playing somebody. Fala. Moon is on White Main. Bob is on the Muradin. And we've got Shoopuff on Artanis. I was staring at that combo and I didn't know what the heck I was looking at. Durotan's couch. I just Fizzed on Diablo. Yawners on the Zul'jin. Goliath playing Stukov. Idioms on Uther. And it is Wildcard on the Sonya. Game number two is now underway. Uther going with the Wave of Light W quest here at level one. Artanis going with the dings. Unbelievable. Can you believe it? Fala going for the Q quest. Stack that extra burst. And Hondo going for scatter quest. Flip train goes on to Bob. Muradin going down a little bit here. Ooh, Hanzo eating some damage from that lurking arm. His Yawners just wanting to step up and auto attack all game long. We see Ding Tanis up here on the top line fighting against Wildcard. Ooh, stun there from Bob onto the front, but Diablo counters. Bob able to jump back to safety. There's that burst healing from White Mane that's going to be so crucial for Heroically Challenged in this one. Is that stacks or is that reactive? Oh, that's reactive. Okay. So the two is the charges. It's not Protector of Iron. My bad, team. My bad, it's not dings. Yawners run down at the gate there. Zul'jin not able to get away. Nice pickup there from Heroically Challenged. Yeah, okay. So Artanis goes for the physical armor on level one. Understandable versus this highly, you know, auto attack focused comp from Durotan's couch. Bottom camp going over to Heroically Challenged here. Zul'jin sitting on six stacks out of 30 on that baseline quest so far. Sonya having to go back to base there. There's a pin into the wall. Bob is going to be stunned. Oh, but the lurking arm was just off placement there. Bob was not silenced and is able to jump back to safety. Hanzo and Artanis working on the top camp heal here. Wildcard sees it, but does not want to get into a 1v2. Moon doing really good work here on the odd number defense. Heroically Challenged having a great early game versus what's usually a tough setup into a double healer. Really strong in the early game. Both teams getting their shaman camps ready to go. Wildcard just healing on the wave a little bit with that whirlwind. Yawners is going to start flinging them axes. Aegis Fizz can't quite get the pin onto AoE rules. They go after Bob once again, but Muradin jumps back to safety. Goliath in the front line taking some hits there. Now Moon is the target. The revolving axe is not going to be enough. So much white main burst healing as now Idiom's getting run down by AoE rules. It's a trade out onto Muradin though. Hanzo able to get ahead on the immortal burn for heroically challenged. Wildcard still trying to deal with the bottom side here as AoE rules chewing on this wall. Both teams trying to just burn their immortals down as quickly as possible, but it looks like heroically challenged going to win that face-off. They've got the sevens, they've got the immortal moving up the top side, and they've also got a fight here in the mid. Shoopuff taking some hits. Ooh, Sonya does end up going down. I kept checking on that bottom fight. I move away and there's finally a takedown. Heroically challenged. Really pushing the pace here. Are going to pick up this bottom fort. Pick that up no problem. Durotan's couch. On the back foot here, but they will be looking for that level 10 power spike to open up their teamfight potential. Heroically challenged, though, saying we're going to take as much as we can before you can get to that point, though. Already damaging the keep wall here in the bottom lane. Yawners having to head on back here. Bottom fort lies in ruins. Cortana's coming to relieve Hanzo. Looks like bottom camp goes over to heroically challenged. No trouble at all. Aegis Fizz going to be walking in on the evidence there. Wildcard's got to watch out. It's still a 1v2 situation. Both teams rotating though. Aegis Fizz looking for anyone to pin, but Moon and AoE rules wisely staying away from those walls, so they're just going to have to try onto Muradin. Bob jumping out of harm's way. Quick stun goes out onto Hanzo. Cortana swapping into the mix, gets that short unstoppable. Bob jumps in, there's the stun from Uther. Shoopuff being blocked there, nice silencing arm as Wildcard now joins in the chase. They get the pin onto Bob, there's the flip once again. Big heals though coming in from Whitemane. Save the Dwarf King once again, and it's Stukov going down. Shoopuff continues to move in as Diablo is the next to be taken out here. AoE rules chasing on forward. Wildcard trying to trade out. It's Zul'jin next to go down, though. Hanzo looking for more. Wildcard moves away. They get the Uther as well. Heroically challenged. It's looking super duper strong here on Battlefield of Eternity. They've got their tens. We've got the Suppression Pulse and the Reign of Vengeance unlocked. Waiting for the rest to lock in here. Dragon Arrow's the choice. Muradin and Whitemane still considering. Whitemane goes for the Scarlet Aegis. And Muradin still holds that 10. Durotan's couch still a level away as Muradin did end up picking the Avatar. Durotan's couch now down to just keeps. Bob monitoring this front side, but it looks like Durotan's couch just going to pick up the camp, not going to worry about stepping up to the immortal without their tens. So this will be a full shield immortal and a camp going over here. AoE rules got to watch out. Taking a lot of damage though, putting their trust into Moon. Our glory radiates through this land. Shaman camp for the bottom lane. Full shield immortal for the top lane. Durotan's couch just trying to hang on here. See if level 10 switches their fortunes. The heavens shall triumph this day. I will bring And it's putting the pressure here onto Sonya. Wildcard mounts up, and there's the tens. Got Flailing Swipe, Lightning Breath, Divine Shield, Leap, and Guillotine here for Zul'jin. Gutsy call from Yawners. Evolving Axe is going out. Pressure continues here in the top lane. Level 13's now online for Heroically Challenged. Big blind onto the back, hits four. Just trying to create some space here. Diablo wanting to step forward and find someone. Dragon Arrow gonna hit onto two here. There's the engage. Uh-oh, Invulnerable has to go out onto Zul'jin. Does it look like that Immortal Stun was about to get the takedown? Upkeep is going to go down here. There's a stun, though. Muradin getting hit by that wall. Guillotine into the back. There's the Scarlet Aegis coming out from White Mane. Stuns from Uther are through. That's going to be White Mane traded for Sonya. All the while, though, Artanis is just trying to take out this bottom keep solo. AoE rules. Not going to make it out of there by the looks of things. Or will they? Oh, Diablo with the chase and the knockdown. Computex looking for idioms, but not going to get it. Shoopuff, though, ushering this catapult forward. That might just be bottom keep going down. Goliath continuing to duel with Hanzo here. Keep will be saved for the moment, but the last shreds of it are the only structure that Durotan's couch has left. I think Wildcard saw Hanzo there. Muradin watching as well, as Durotan's couch looking at bottom camp. Durotan's couch gonna pick that one up. Top lane being pushed, two catapults there. About to have 13s as Durotan's couch, so it's even talent tiers for a potential team fight, if that's what they're gonna look for, but top wave is starting to build up, so they're gonna have to look quickly. Looks like Sonya's just breaking away to deal with that, and there's going to be a camp behind to clear as well. Durotan's couch decides to break away here. It's Artanis pushing up here. Repent before my wrath, demon. Objective is rolling. Rogue challenge just, you know, saying to Durotan's couch, you can take one thing, but we're going to get another. They've got top lane pushing in. They're trying to work the objective. There's a triple stun and the silent or the blind going out. That is both healers down. Durotan's couch looking to run away, but Yawner's in serious trouble here. Will be taken out. AoE rules running down. I just fizzed next. Diablo will fall in a soul reset. Sonya never even got to make it to the fight. Still dealing with that top lane death ball of minions. Heroically challenged, looking heroically unstoppable here in game number two. Another full shield immortal coming in next. Gonna focus on I Just Fizz. Diablo in trouble, receives the D shield. Oh no! Overstepping though was Muradin. The keep does go down. That's a timely pick here. Oh, Diablo goes down, but Wildcard jumps into the back. Big blind from Artanis. Moon trying to get away. That is going to be White Mane going down. Hanzo gets slammed down next. Wildcard trying to get Vala here. Vala too fast. Wildcard having to double back. Shoopuff wanting to trade out here. Ooh. No swap attempt. Yawners does finish up the quest, but now the Immortal is moving in on the core. Might scratch the core a little bit here. Durotan's couch clearing with speed now. Down to 81%. Durotan's couch getting some very welcome catch-up experience, though. One more wave and they'll be at 16. Durotan's couch just going right across the map. They know they've got to keep on fighting. Wildcard goes in and contests the camp. There's the guillotine onto the point. I Just Fizz pushing into the back. Bob stepping up here as Artanis hits the blind once again. Big stun from Mahanzo. Scatter is amazing as now, oh, Vala traded for Zul'jin and for Stukov. Uther, the only one trying to get away here. White Mane goes down at the gate, but Uther falls on the chase as well. Ends up being a 3-for-2 there for the side of Heroically Challenged. Durtan's Couch ends up getting the Shaman Camp, but look at these catapults collapsing top and bottom here. Sonya going to clear away the top catapults as the bottom catapult's stepping in. They're looking for Diablo under this core. I just fizzed. Ooh, moving around here, does have the souls. Core shielding is starting to go down though. Wildcard just focusing those catapults, 79% and counting. Heroically Challenged, forced to retreat. Top lane's starting to collapse once again. Portal's getting ready to spawn. Durotan's Couch showing they're not done, but they've got a big, big mountain to climb here. Shaman Camp should relieve a little bit of pressure from the lanes right now. Sonya making sure there's no gank coming on the top side, but Heroically Challenged just going to put the pressure on with another Immortal. At least that's the plan. Shoopuff pushed away. Bob going in there as the Lightning Breath is well timed from Diablo. Leap from Wildcard. That is White Mane pops. Computex in trouble. That's Hanzo going down. Big blind from Artanis buys 4 seconds here. Now Shoopuff being pushed away. Bottom lane is starting to collapse into the core though. Wildcard has to back out and deal with that. Durotan's Couch is still 4v3 though on this point, so still with the advantage here. Shoopuff working the edge as Bob goes in. Nice Divine Shield. Yawners though in some trouble. Zul'jin trying to find a safe space to work right now. Sonya saving the core on the bottom side and Durotan's Couch. Look like they're set to pick up this Immortal. Fall on the top side, just getting rid of some of this shielding. But Durotan's Couch will be the ones wielding this Immortal to push through the top lane. Heroically Challenged, going to have their 20s here for this defense. White Mane and Hanzo about to break out of the Hall of Storms once again. Sonya keeping the bottom lane in check. Hanzo and White Mane are here. Shoopuff trying to engage, is going to be stunned out by Uther. Yawner's trying to get away here, gets cleansed. Little bit of extra movement speed, but Hanzo catching up. Uther with the burst healing. Yawner's does not have the ult. Oh no, that's Zul'jin going down. Stukov falls as well. Big Scarlet Aegis there from the White Mane. Diablo trying to breathe on through it somehow. Wildcard continuing to survive, ultimately goes down. I just fizzed falls as well. That's a soul reset. Idiom's going to be caught and removed. That is a full team wipe here from Heroically Challenged. Diablo's back, but that is not going to be enough for this defense. No minions, but no problem here. Heroically Challenged move in towards the core, and they are going to even up this series. Very nice counter drafting there. Showing what the power of, you know, just that reactive drafting can be. Even up the series 1-1, we're going to a game number 3. Very cool stuff there from Heroically Challenged, just controlling that all game long. Durotan's Couch, they had a path on the way back there. They still had a couple more team fights to win. But they were on their way, but Heroically Challenged shut them down. Let's go to the post game. Checking out the stats here. AoE rules on the Vala, over 91,000 on the hero damage for that Q build. Shoopuff on the Artanis, a zero death game there. Topping it out on the siege damage. For Durotan's Couch, Yawners on that Zul'jin, 51,000 on the hero damage. Take a look at the talents. Let's update the scoreboard and get prepped for game 3. Alrighty. It's Sky Temple coming up next. This one chosen by Heroically Challenged. Let's go to the draft. All right, we made it. Don't worry. I put up the caster R. Neither team put an R in chat, and then the draft started. Hope they're ready. Hope they're all ready to go. Durotan's Couch going to be coming in with the first pick here on Sky Temple. Is it an Abathur game? It 100% is. We'll see which team gets it. Who is ready for Abathur time? There's exactly one map in Heroes of the Storm where Abathur becomes competitively viable unless you're just having a fun time, and it's this one. Dahaka going to be banned out by Durotan's Couch. Who's got the Abathur? Let me know in chat which team is taking the Abathur, and if you say neither, to try and be right and correct, you know how it is. Augur banned out here by Heroically Challenged. Am I on a team? I am on Regen Rebel this season. Division C East. That's where I'm at. How you doing, Malevial? Durotan's Couch next to Act here. See if they want to control maybe a Falstad. They're going to get rid of Hanzo here and try to put Computex onto something different. A little change in the strategy there. Heroically Challenged on the next ban. Boss control is a big deal here on Sky Temple. So we might see some Falstad control. We might see... You know, already got the Hogger Band, that's a big one. Yarel is a good one that can wrestle over the boss. Junkrat, great boss control hero, taken out here by Heroically Challenged. Tyrael's one that can come up here as well with that Holy Ground. Wildcard taking the Blaze first for Durotan's Couch. Let's see, Heroically Challenged. What if they just juice them? Is it juice o'clock? Do people juice in Heroic? Bob going for the Johanna, Computex taking Vala. Standard power picks coming on through. Durotan's Couch, they've got the Blaze. I think a Falstad would be pretty neat here, but that does leave you a little bit open later in the draft. You might want to hold that one. Anduin Genji locked in. I was a little worried that if they take the Falstad, the other team would take that Anduin Genji, but they just decide I'll just take it myself, and then I can take the Falstad. Super easy. Pretty lethal opening here from Durotan's Couch, but Johanna Vala, not too bad themselves. Heroically Challenged looking across here, going to get rid of Diablo, because they've already got their tank locked in. Durotan's Couch, let's see. Brightwing might be one that they remove. They've already got their healer. They've got the Genji on side. Takes out a global as well. Let's see what they're thinking here for this ban. What do we got? It's a Brightwing ban. All right, next two here. Is it Abathur time? Chen and Abathur. Chen and Abathur. Chen and Abathur. Come on, do it, Heroically Challenged. You know you wanna. Alright. Let's see what they actually pick. Next two here. Lucio Imperius. Ooh, that's fun. Our first Lucio of the day. Imperius gonna try to counter-engage onto the Blaze there. Genji a tough one to catch, but that at the tip of that spear is quite large hitbox, so sometimes Genji gets hit when you feel like you've dodged it. going big time aggro here, is heroically challenged. I just fizzed taking Anubarak idioms on the Sylvanas. So that's a split siege duo that sometimes we see on Sky Temple, just cheesing down some walls. AoE rules goes back to the Artanis.
Yes. Yes.
We love Artanis here in the chat. So we got double bruiser with the Vala, Lucio to give movement speed to everybody. We've got the Genji bomb with the side soak. This is going to be a tight clash. This is going to be awesome. Are you ready for game number 3, chat? You should be. Because we took appropriate breaks. Here we go. Game number 3 in our best of 3 today. On the left of the blue, it is heroically challenged. Moon is on the Vala. Shoepuff playing Imperius. AoE rules on the Artanis. Bob playing Joanna. And we've got Computex on the Lucio. Little switcheroo there on the rolls. On the right in the red, Duratan's Couch. Wildcard on the Blaze. Idioms on Sylvanas. I just fizzed on the Anubarak. Goliath playing Anduin. And Yawners on the Diablo. Or on the Genji. Wouldn't that be scary? Teleporting Diablo. Sylvanas moving into the bottom lane here. Anubarak going to deposit the Beetles. The siege commences. Beetles have been deposited. Bob coming on down to try to gather someone up. Only able to lock in the Anubarak. Mutex, walking into the wrong neighborhood there. That is Lucio going down. At least one of those ninja stars connecting there from Genji. Duratan's Couch picks up first blood. First blood. Yawners jumping out of trouble there as we're approaching camp timings here at the 1 minute mark. Team's going to go ahead and move over to that. Bob coming across the map here, threatening to invade. Even just, you know, poking your head in forces the enemy team to not just leave one on that camp for safety reasons. So Bob never intended to invade there, at least the first time. Now he intends to invade. But just by showing your face, you force the enemy team to think about it. They're stepping up here. Swap coming out onto Idioms. Sylvanas goes back to safety. Here's Computex trying to work that back line. A lot of damage going out onto Lucio once again. Heroically challenged. Well, not going to stick around and continue that one. Duratan's Couch picks up their camp. Ooh, Yawners was going for a quick one there. Jumps over the wall. Artanis gives chase. Yawners in trouble. Is running out of cooldowns. Oh, I'm coughing. I'm so jacked up about it. Genji goes down. Artanis. Yes. Big Artanis plays. Woo. All right. Good job, team. The team with the Artanis gets the kill. And that's all I could ever ask for. Ooh, Goliath taking a lot of hits there. They're trying to trade onto Moon. If those minions weren't there, I think Vala is one dead demon hunter. Approaching our first temples being called here. Top and mid, as is always the case. Bruiser camp's now going to be focused for both sides. Duratan's Couch doing top right. We got heroically challenged getting their top left out. Sylvanas sticking around on the low side for now. Getting too hyped up about this Artanis play, man. Temple's ready to be captured as bruisers are taken by both sides. Anubarak just going to keep on scouting. Lucio doing Lucio things, as it looks like Duratan's Couch going to focus on the top side. AoE rules trying to trade out with Idioms there. Checking back in on the top. Shoepuff, nice stun there onto Yawners. Genji getting away. Goliath in some trouble here. Caught on the wrong side of this engagement. Anduin goes down. Seven's in, four heroically challenged. Uh-oh, big trouble here for AoE rules. Yawners trying to move up there. Artanis is going to get taken out. So Durotan's couch trying to control here. Uh-oh, oh no, idioms, oh no! Sylvanas got pulled in by Johanna and then bopped by the minion. Unfortunate there for Durotan's couch. So this is going to be the majority of these shots going over to heroically challenged. Last five getting poured into the mid wall. My temple's power. I just fizzed. Ooh, going after Lucio there. Computex is going to be hit. Goliath trying to come on down for a hit, but Lucio escapes on the low side. Heroically challenged, now getting their left side camp done. Durotan's couch. Gonna try to rip this right side before an invade comes, but Bob is looking once again. Chastise used there by Goliath. Johanna gonna try to step up. AoE rules caught there by Anubarak. There's the follow-up, though, onto Computex. Oh, Lucio can't boost away. No boostio for Lucio. Heroically challenged. Gets ganked before they can get their tens, and the camp goes over to Durotan's couch once again. We're past the 5 minute mark, which means the bottom side boss is available. Heroically challenged is about to have their tens, which means they might just rip this boss straight away. Tens are here. We've got Purifier Beam, Rain of Vengeance, High Five, Blessed Shield. Blessed Shield going out, not connecting there from Bob. Imperius still waiting on that level 10. Durotan's couch trying to soak up those tens as we speak. Tens are in. It is Wrath of the Angiris here for Imperius. Wailing Arrow, Cocoon, Bunker, Light Bomb, and X-Strike. Your choices for Durotan's couch. Tens are online. How will the fights change from here? AoE rules, we'll see. I just fizzed here on the edge. Shoepuff looking at Yawners. Genji has to get away. Oh, Anubarak trying to walk it back to safety. Shoepuff goes in for the stun. Bob stepping in as well. I just fizzed, nowhere to go. Goliath trying to get the pull out. Doesn't get it. Oh, Genji has dropped in. Rain of Vengeance to follow it up. And Genji is taken down. The follow-up is fantastic. Light Bomb connects, but Idiom still falls. Goliath going to be chased out here by the Purifier Beam. Because that is a triple takedown for Heroically Challenged. Now they're looking at this boss. Artanis did go dings on level 1 this game. Definitely confirmed here. 115 stacks so far. Boss is taken by Heroically Challenged. Bottom side temple is available. Boss marching down the bottom lane, heroically challenged, going to try to get a fork here. Getting value on two fronts. Imperius working on the back camp solo right now, so Durotan's couch. Let's see if they can find a fight opportunity as Blaze is coming down to visit. Fort will fall here. Computex stunned out by Wildcard. Blaze throwing out a little bit of damage. Yawner's stepping up onto Bob. Swapping out of trouble. Light Bomb comes out. X-Strike lands onto Artanis, but there's the Unstoppables from Lucio. Falla put into the cocoon here as Goliath chased out by the beam from Artanis once again. Idiom's in some trouble here. Tries to get the warp out to safety. Anduin is going to get run down. Sylvanas falls next. Anubarak and Blaze trying to walk it away, but the damage chase is too strong. Lucio just bringing that movement speed. Bob catches up to Anubarak. Yawners will get away. Blaze, probably not going to be so lucky. There we go. That's a quad for Heroically Challenged. Wow. Looking very good here on Sky Temple. Top lane Bruiser Camp was pushing all that time. Mid fort is down. Artanis getting the last couple shots out of this bottom side objective. Durictan's couch find themselves reeling once again. A 3-level deficit. Bottom side keep wall is ravaged here. We've got a catapult and a siege camp stepping in. Durictan's couch want to find their 13s before they go in on this fight if possible. There's the 13s. Genji coming around here. Oh, nice route there onto Artanis. AoE rules caught in the chastise. Yawners with the light bomb. Stun onto two. X strike onto Computex. That is Lucio going down. Goliath getting away from the ult there, but Anubarak is going to fall. AoE rules taking a lot of poison damage though on the edge. That's Anduin traded for Artanis. Very low is Sylvanas next to go down. Wildcard, oh, is caught by the Wrath of Angiras once again. Moon trying to get away from Wildcard. There goes Genji, but Fala falls too. It's 4-for-3 so far. Wildcard trying to walk it away. There's the slow, but Johanna catching up. Jet propulsion. Wildcard is, oh, Bob's waiting for that cooldown. The Johanna movement speed on 7. Oh no, Blaze is just going to get run down. Ends up being 5-for-3 there for Heroically Challenged. Yeah, that level 7 from Johanna. Where is it? There it is. Gain 10% movement speed. Increased up to 20% while Condemn is charging up. Durotan's couch. Doing what they can here. It is a single temple phase. That is an opportunity for them to possibly find a fight and make up some ground. Oh no, it's a double. There's one on the bottom side as well. Oh, mega unfortunate. So the best they can hope for at this point is a trade. But already on it is Artanis and Imperius. Imperius going to be the one collapsed onto here. Shoepuff on the retreat is going to find the Anubarak. Double stun there from the light bomb engage. Bob, though, up on the top side. Shoepuff trying to turn around with that Wrath of Angiras does not connect. Artanis holding out the bottom side shots. Computex once again just going straight in there. Blaze goes down on the top side. Vala falls next. Goliath being run down by the Lucio and by the ult of the Artanis, as this fight is on multiple fronts here. Computex in some trouble. Lucio goes down. Goliath, though, trying to get away from Bob, will do so. Nice unstoppable from Johanna, but will it be enough? Nice blind. Ooh, Bob trying to get away here, gets through the minion wave. Root goes out onto Artanis. Shoepuff goes down. Durotan's couch once again showing life while behind here in the mid game. Artanis, though, just stacking this bottom lane. Blaze has returned and will have to deal with that. Bruiser camp to be stolen by Durotan's couch. Artanis making their way back here. Blaze has got a double camp to deal with. The rest of the team's got a double camp to push with. Lucio about to be back. Still 18 seconds, though, on Imperius. I just fizz going over the wall to find Moon. Light Bomb comes out as well. Stun onto Vala. Moon is in trouble. Durotan's couch find a pick here. Very timely. That's going to give Blaze more time to push out the bottom lane. Durotan's couch trying to move away. I just fizz swapped into the action though. IOA rules keeps wanting to fight here. Goliath gets the ult once again. Unstoppable comes out from Lucio. And it looks like this fight is going to happen whether Durotan's couch wants it or not. Artanis eats the silence and starts to peel away here, and that is the cue for Heroically Challenged to back up as Blaze was approaching from that flank. Now we do have a single temple phase coming up next in the top lane. Durotan's couch trying to pick that up, and all of a sudden, things looking not quite so one-sided here. Though bottom lane continues to be a problem for Durotan's couch with those constant catapults. Uh-oh, Heroically Challenged may have him pinched here. Bob is going to try to gather up two. Idioms warping out to safety. AoE rules. Tries to get a stun. Yawners can't get the hit into the back line as Artanis shields keep on resetting. Still, Artanis is going to go down here, though. I just fizz trying to find Lucio on the flank. Durotan's couch getting another timely pickup. Wildcard having to back here. So once again, the wave is building up. Blaze will be dealing with that, no problem. Last shots going into the bottom fort wall of Heroically Challenged. Heroically Challenged does have their 20s, but they don't have Artanis for another 25 seconds. Ooh, Anubarak was looking. Heroically Challenged, though, were already mounted and escaping. Durotan's couch gonna try to rip this boss. Artanis is not up for 11 seconds here. Heroically Challenged, they know this is happening. Shoot Buff gonna move in here. Yawner's stepping up just to help finish this off. Durotan's couch is gonna grab the boss. Wildcard still having to back to deal with this lane. We've got the catapults building once again. Siege camp as well. So this boss likely not gonna get too far as Heroically Challenged have 5 on the defense. Shoopuff looking for I Just Fizzed here. Yawner's remaining out of sight here on the left, but Shoopuff gets the discovery. Genji getting out of there. Uh-oh, Goliath pulled in by Artanis. Self-Light Bomb comes out, gonna get a stun onto 4. Big trouble here for Heroically Challenged. Can they weather the storm? Moon getting healed up quickly. Anubarak goes down. Genji falls next. Great healing there from Lucio. Wildcard can't get back to the bunker. That is Blaze to fall. Goliath and Idiom still alive, but Computex with the rundown here. This looks like it's going to be it. Heroically Challenged have the bottom lane open. There's the swap. Idioms is going to live. I doubt the core is. Heroically Challenged holding on there. Durotan's couch putting up a mighty fight in the last couple minutes there, but just not quite enough. Sylvanas is going to be taken out there. And the core will fall. Heroically Challenged come back and get the 2-1 series victory. GG. Very nicely done, Heroically Challenged. Showing their strength after getting taken down game number 1. Come on back and take the series. Solid performance all around. What can I say? Artanis wins games. Let's go to the post game. Checking out the stats here. Moon on the Vala, top hero damage for Heroically Challenged with the 51,000. 0 deaths for Bob on that Johanna. Over on the side of Durotan's couch, Sylvanas, Idioms, over 70,000 hero damage, nearly 71 there. Quite the entertaining series indeed. Let's get the scoreboard updated and we'll see if we can reach out for an interview with our winning team. Looks like I'm gonna have one coming on through. So let's get prepped. Blazing Moon, congrats on the 2-1 victory.
Thank you.
Big comeback there in that series. Durotan's couch had you on the ropes there after game number 1, but it looked like the energy really switched it up there for game 2. You just sort of came in with a plan that didn't quite work out there in game number 1, or was there a change in mindset with that second draft?
The first game, the team comp was our first time trying it.
Okay.
More so like we had the combos down, we just never executed as a group. And if you saw like in the later team fights, there were a lot of misplays or synergy.
Mm-hmm.
I will say, though, Durotan's put up a massive fight. We've scrimmed them before, so we had an expectation of like their play style, and they superseded that, and want to give lots of respect to their synergy.
It was, it was definitely a hard-fought battle all the way to the end there. Both on Battlefield of Eternity and Sky Temple, it looked like they were just fully out of it by the mid-game, but then started clawing their way back. Did you have to sort of like reset your comms and go, okay, you know, we had this, let's just get back to what we were doing? Or did you feel confident through the end of both of those?
Uh, There were some shaky moments, have to admit, especially the second game. There were moments when we could have ended, but we decided to be more aggressive than normal. And that's just a trait that our team is working on.
Well, worked out pretty well today. Yeah, I mean, I guess this is the Artanis stream. We got some Artanis games today. Yeah. Is that an AoE rules special? Is that something you feel like more teams could take advantage of?
AoE is such a wild card, and I love seeing it. And we're confident as a team to see him pull it off.
I'll pull it off. He absolutely did. Two wins on the hierarchy today. Very nicely done. We're starting to approach the midpoint in the season here for Heroic. You know, most teams have 4 or 5 matches under their belt by now. Looking at the later half of the schedule, are there any teams that you're really looking forward to facing? Or, you know, how do you feel like your schedule looks in the second half?
We definitely had it rough fighting MLG first league. We'll have to admit to that. And some of the other higher tier teams at the beginning. The one that we're looking forward to the most would be Cowboys. We have yet to scrim them. We have yet to fight their full 5-man. So that's the team I'm most looking forward to.
We'll be looking out for that one for sure. Moon, grats on the 2-1 victory. Well-deserved. Any shout-outs you'd like to make before we close out?
Would like to shout out Dirton's Couch. You guys played awesome. Definitely gave us a running and letting you guys know we had one match won against MLG. You guys beat us. Hopefully you guys have that too. I believe in you guys. Like to shout out our team as well. The synergy, the comms, we're getting better. We're a brand new team in Heroic, so I am very proud of our group so far. And Thank you for the cool shotcasting, and I love to review what you've said.
Well, the spoiler-free VOD will be out tomorrow, but the live cast will be available right after this. So whenever you want to watch it, it'll be right there.
Really appreciate that.
My pleasure. Well, thank you so much for coming on by. Grats again on the win, and good luck going through the rest of the season.
Yeah, have a good night.
Have a good one. Bye.